Time.
Okay.
Go.
Hello, church. Tonight, amen, is our regular service. It's Thursday the 16th, 17th, 16th?
16th.
And so we can't have service at church, but we want to just share a few things, a few testimonies that God has done during this coronavirus and during the revival. And then we want to take turns and different people give testimonies. So tonight we have a few testimonies. And so we just want you to be blessed, sit down and listen to these testimonies, be encouraged. We're also going to sing a few songs and you guys can sing along with us and you're going to be very blessed.
Yes, mijo.
Check. Is it on? Okay, good. So, hello there. I just want to say today, thank you for watching this video. But most of all, I want to let you know that God has a plan for your life, okay? Now, those are not just random words. God really has a plan for your life. One of the things is, one, he has a plan for my life, and he's driven me out from my life of sin, from things in areas in my life that I've always struggled with, or the case in many cases, drunk, being a drunk and stuff like that. God has delivered me, set me free from being a drunk. Has set me free from so many things that I would like to share with you. But in the little bit of time that I got, I want to say that God has a plan for your life. God is real. God wants to do something in you. Now, I'm not saying I'm perfect or whatever the case might be, but I know one thing. God is amazing. And through the midst of this coronavirus, I am a person that likes to go every single fellowship, every house. Okay, I like to go different places and stuff. Well, guess what? I can't do that. So in this time, I've come to a point where I've read my Bible more. And as I read my Bible more, there's a lot of good stuff in there that you can learn how to live throughout your day. Like, I've learned stuff that I should have known years back. But because, you know, just I didn't read it, whether it be I didn't have time or whatever the case might be, I read it. And let me tell you something, the Word of God is so real. I know, no joke, one verse from, like, let's say Matthew chapter 4, verse 1 to 4. That little verse changed my life. I mean, it changes the courses of your life. So I want to testify with you that if you read your word, you will get something out of it. Whether it be 1 second, 1 minute, whatever. And if you just enjoy God in the midst of this and just meditate in the things of God, the supernatural, what he speaks about in the Bible, and let it through every single day as you live it, you will see an improvement in your life. Obviously, be aware, you know, there's things on earth that try to pull us, but that's their daily battle as a Christian. It's every single day, and you have to make a choice every single day. Am I going to do this, or am I going to go here? Am I going to do this, or am I going to read? And guess what? You will fail. But the thing about Jesus Christ is John 3:16, for he loved the world so much. That's a supernatural gift that you can experience every single day. So I want to say thank you. God bless you.
In Espanol, a little.
In Spanish too? Okay. Dios, but God bless you. Anyways, Espanol ahora. So, Dios quiere cambiar su vida. Hoy este día quiere hacer algo supernatural en tu vida. So, quiero decir que si lees tu Biblia aunque sea un versículo de Mateo 1 al 4, y tú lo lees, vas a ver algo supernatural. O sea, es un ejemplo, ¿verdad? So, léelo y escucha de Dios, y cuando estés solo, habla a Dios, sé respondoso con Dios y decir, oiga Dios, miras el corazón. O en el trabajo, algo pasa en tu corazón, en el trabajo, decir algo, tú sabes lo que hablo. Dios, fíjate, tú llama, fíjate mi corazón, Señor. Sé honesto cuando tú estás con tu esposa y tu esposo y es algo, hey, tenemos que hablar, hey, igual con Dios, hey, Dios, mira, si miras, mira, siempre he fallado aquí, necesito cambio, mira, sé honesto con Dios, es lo primero en una relación, ser honesto, y es allí donde hay la mercy de Dios, misericordia, cae y te da vida, ok, so, ama a Dios, Jesús te salva, amén.
En tu presencia, postrando todo mi ser ante ti, y canto con gozo tu presencia, amándote, adorándote, Señor, llenándome, Señor, de tu presencia, conociendo día a día tu amor. Habito confiado en tu presencia, dándote por siempre mi amor. Estando yo, Señor, en tu presencia, usando todo mi ser ante ti, y canto con gozo en tu presencia, amándote, adorándote, Señor, llenándome, Señor, de tu presencia, conociendo día a día tu amor. Habito confiado en tu presencia, dándote por siempre mi amor.
Llenándome, Señor, de tu presencia.
Llenándome, Señor, de tu presencia, conociendo día a día tu amor. Habito confiado en tu presencia, dándote por siempre mi amor.
Bueno, hermanos, Dios los bendiga, Dios los guarde. Los amo en Cristo, a mis hermanas, a mis hermanos también, a los jóvenes también. Nomás voy a decir una cosa, que al principio yo era un fariseo bien hecho, cuando era, recién me convertí, pero el Señor me ha cambiado, ya no soy un fariseo, Dios me cambió mi corazón. Pues ese es mi testimonio, que Dios me cambió mi corazón. Pues Dios me los bendiga y los guarde a todos.
Amén. Go ahead.
Good evening, brothers, sisters. I'm here in the presence of God with a lot of brothers here too that are praising God and thanking Him for His mercy. I thank God for this day that He gave me, and even though it's been different for me during this trials that we're having and these different times, God has shown to me that His hand and His power is within me and in us, in our home, around us. God has given us a great gift, and I thank Him every day for it. When my mind starts to wander off, or I start getting kind of a little bit antsy because of what's occurring, and I can't do this or do that or go like I used to go, get up and go somewhere, I always refocus and I thank God, because my daughter that we have been praying for so long has finally come to the Lord.
Amen.
In December, my son-in-law came to me and he said, Mama, he gave me a hug and he said, Mama, don't worry, me and Jeannie are now serving the Lord and we're going to the Rock Church. So it has been a tremendous blessing to us. We had her in prayer for many years, and I remember my sister used to tell me, the Lord is faithful, and if I am dead and do not get to see it, she will come to the Lord. And God has kept His promise because we know He is faithful. During this Easter time, their Resurrection Day that we call, so we were at home, a few of us just gathered to have a family dinner, and during this time it was so fabulous, because before, it's really hard when you have a group of unsaved and saved, because if the saved people don't have that liberty, because they'll kind of, you know, shut you down, or they'll have their music on, or they'll have their TV programs on, and it's just kind of not a good atmosphere. But during this Christmas, we were so blessed, because during this Easter, we were so blessed because my daughter, like I said, came to the Lord. My son-in-law is there. We're all praising God. Carlos is asking us questions from the Bible. Everybody's raising their hand to answer. We go around the table. Everybody's saying thanks to God for something that's in their heart. It was just so fabulous that it filled my heart with joy. And all that is worth serving the Lord. When you see your family come, when you see that God keeps his promises. Because you know what? We are faulty. We don't keep our promises sometimes. We say, well, I'll be there. And then last minute is, I don't feel like it. I'll call and say, I'm sorry, I can't make it. Or I promise something, I don't keep my promise. But God is faithful. He's always been faithful. My niece got also converted during this Easter luncheon that we had, or dinner. She was there, and we started talking about the things of God. After my daughter had left, we gathered and still start talking about the Lord. We're praying in a circle, and she says, I want to accept God.
So oh, right away, glory to God.
She accepted the Lord. We uploaded or downloaded, however you say it. I'm not from the cybernetic age here. We put her on the Living Bible, and like you said, video Bible. We put it in her phone, installed it for her. And I told my sister, you got charged. You know, my sister's a Christian. I don't want to take too much time, but I cannot help tell you this. I am just super, super happy and grateful to God. First generation, my grandmother came to the Lord. Second generation, my mother came to the Lord. Third generation, which is all five kids, we have come to the Lord. Fourth generation, praise God, all our kids are coming. My daughter, my sister's daughter, now her son. God is great. God is wonderful. I'll leave you with one Bible verse because I know we're all anxious to talk. Isaiah 41:10 says, fear not, for I am with thee. Be not afraid, for I am your God. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand and protect you. God bless.
Head in Spanish.
Hermanos, me ha pedido el pastor que hable poquito en español. Miren, le estaba contando aquí a los hermanos que ahora en la cena que hicimos para el Día de Resurrección, estaba mi hija y mi yerno que ahora ya aceptaron al Señor, fue por gracia de Dios y una promesa cumplida. Pero durante ese tiempo estábamos orando y se fue mi hija y su esposo, se despidieron, pero se quedó mi hermana con sus hijas y su nieta y ahí hicimos una congregación pequeña y oramos por ellas. Y mi sobrina aceptó a Dios, reconoció que es pecadora, reconoció que necesita a Dios, reconoció que ha hecho tantas faltas delante de Dios y se humilló a Él. Y por eso le doy gracias al Señor por la salvación de mi sobrina. Le digo al pastor y a los hermanos que Dios es tan grande que en mi casa desde la primera hasta la cuarta generación hemos sido salvos. Empezó con mi abuela que en su grande edad dio la vida al Señor y luego mi madre y ahora los cinco hijos hemos aceptado a Dios. Y nuestros hijos también ya están aceptando a Dios. Estamos esperando la quinta generación, que viene siendo ahora los hijos de nuestros hijos. Yo no tengo ni uno, pero mi hermana quizá tenga una hija que quizá ya esté más grande de edad, tiene como 17 años. Pero yo le doy gracias a Dios por todo lo que hace, por todo lo que está haciendo y por todo lo que hará. Porque Dios es grande y para siempre su misericordia. Y dice el Señor que no temamos, que Él está con nosotros y nunca nos dejará. ¿Sí?
Thank you, Lord. And I just want to thank you. And I just want to thank you. Thank you, Lord. And I just want to thank you. And I just want to thank you, Lord.
I just want
to take a little time right now and say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. And I just want to take a little time right now and say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Thank you, Lord. And I just want to thank you. And I just want to thank you. Thank you, Lord. And I just want to thank you. And I just want to thank you, Lord. And I just want to take a little time right now and say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. And I just want to take a little time right now and say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Thank you, oh, thank you, Lord. And I just want to thank you. And I just want to, yes, thank you.
Thank you,
Lord. And I just want to thank you. And I just want to thank you. Lord.
Okay, go ahead, sir.
Hey, man. Hello, church. This is your bro, B-Dog from Imperial Beach. I'm just kidding. This is Brian. I want to say hello, and God bless you to everyone from the church. In these times, we know that everything that's going on, it's really hard to just, you know, live a normal life. But in the end, it's God is showing his grace upon this earth. I'm still working, I'm still interacting with people, and I've come to the realization that God is showing not only me, but I believe in all the brothers in the church and the sisters, the God of the heart of God, that his heart longs for people, even though we long to be with our Savior, who died for our sin. We know that he is coming back, but in the end, there's also the reality that there's a lot of people that need to get saved, and that's the heart of God, and God is really showing that. And I've gotten the chance to witness to my coworkers. They bring up, you know, a lot of coworkers ask me that are these the end times, and is the world gonna end soon? And I just tell them yes, but the real question is, are you ready for the end time, to see Jesus face to face and stand before him? And but yeah, I just thank God for those opportunities, and I just pray that God move upon those hearts that have been witnessed to, and amen. And hopefully we reap a plentiful harvest, and hopefully God gives us another year. And hermanos, hermanas, les quería decir nomás que hola a todos y Dios los bendiga. También les quiero decir que en estos tiempos, ya sabemos que estamos viviendo en los tiempos finales, y sabemos que Jesucristo viene pronto, pero la realidad es también que, o sea, nosotros queremos estar con nuestro Salvador Jesucristo, que murió por nuestros pecados, pero también está la realidad que hay mucha gente que todavía tiene que ser salva, y que tiene que venir al Señor. Y en estos tiempos mucha gente me ha abierto la oportunidad, me ha abierto la puerta a Dios para hablar con mucha gente sobre Él, y testificar de su grandeza. Y mucha gente me pregunta que si son los tiempos finales, y yo les digo sí, pero también la verdadera pregunta es, ¿estás listo para recibir a Cristo o para estar frente a frente Él en su trono? Pero en estos tiempos Dios más arriba de todo me está enseñando su gracia y su corazón hacia la gente, que todavía hay mucha gente que tiene que ser salva, y yo oro y le pido a Dios que nos dé otro año más para ver a esa gente venir al Señor y así estar todos junto con Él en su trono de gracia. Dios los bendiga. Amén.
Okay.
Hi everyone, this is Perla. Just wanted to say hello, and I wanted to share a little bit about what God did for me during revival services with Peter Ajala. First of all, I want to thank God for all that he did for me and everything that he did in my heart. And I really believe that he really, sometimes I believe some revivals that we have, they're really timely for our lives, because they're able to expose our hearts, and they're able to really to show us what's going on in your heart, and it gives us the opportunity to get right with him and to break those strongholds or generational curses or anything like that. So I just want to just be able to share a little bit of background. One of the sermons that really, really touched my heart was a sermon that was titled The Orphan Spirit. And so Pastor Ajala talked a little bit about, he pretty much made a list about, the different things that you might, it was a list to kind of tell you if you do have the orphan spirit or not. And one of the things he said is that sometimes when you have the orphan spirit, and you know, when there's not a mom or a dad in the picture, and all of a sudden they're not even there, and you don't even miss them, you know. And a lot of you know my testimony, but a lot of people don't. But I was pretty much raised in a very dysfunctional family, and my mom wasn't really there for me or for my family. At the age of 14, she pretty much kicked us out of the house, and my dad pretty much started raising us. And so we've always had a very turmoil relationship. So anyways, I just don't want to bore you with all the details, but fast forward, she was supposed to go to my wedding, and my sister really tried her hardest to be able to have her there. She bought her clothes, she bought her some shoes, but in the end she decided not to go because some of my uncles were gonna go. And so when she found out that they were gonna go, and because she has a lot of bitterness towards them, she decided not to go. And so I really thought it wasn't gonna affect me, you know, because I remember telling Flavio after we got married and we were at the airplane, I was like, you know, I really didn't think that was going to affect me, but it really did affect me, you know.
Yes.
And it really hurt my heart. And you know, I'm the kind of person, I'm like, you know what, God, I'm just going to give it to you, try to give it to you, and just leave it at that and try to move on and try to live life and try to walk with you as much as I can. And then fast forward, January, my father passes away. And so, you know, fast forward there, and, you know, Pastor Peter Ajala preaching this sermon about having an orphan spirit. And that really, really touched my heart, because I realized that I had the orphan spirit because of all the things that have happened. And I was telling Flavio, like, I didn't even realize that I had the orphan spirit until Pastor Peter Ajala preached that sermon, and it really, really exposed my heart to the point where I was able to say, God, here's my heart, take it, I lay everything down in your hands, and heal it, and take it away and break the curse, you know. And and I really felt that something was broken, and I because of that, I felt so alive and so different. I feel very revived and stirred, you know, for his will. So I just really want to thank God for all that he did, and I thank God for the revival.
Amen. Go ahead, Perla.
Hola, ¿cómo están? Dios les bendiga a todos. Mi nombre es Perla. Nada más quería compartir un poquito sobre mi testimonio, y más bien por todo lo que Dios hizo en mi corazón durante el avivamiento de Pastor Peter Ajala. El sermón que de verdad me tocó mi corazón y me cambió mi vida fue el sermón titulado Espíritu Huérfano, teniendo un espíritu de, huérfano. Y básicamente Peter Ajala mencionó diferentes cosas de por qué tienes ese espíritu. Y verdaderamente yo pensaba que yo no hubiera tenido ese espíritu, pero verdaderamente sí lo tenía. Y le doy gracias a Dios por ese avivamiento, porque algunas veces esos avivamientos son para el tiempo que Dios lo usa para que obre nuestros corazones. Y que y pues de verdad Dios me tocó mi corazón, y pues yo estaba muy dolida por lo que había pasado con mi papá, que él falleció en enero, y también más bien por lo que pasó que mi mamá supuestamente iba a ir a la boda. Mi hermana trató de ayudarla, le compró zapatos y un vestido, y nada más porque tenía porque se dio cuenta de que sus hermanos o mis familia de Los Ángeles iban a venir, ella decidió no ir. Y de verdad yo pensaba que eso no me iba a lastimar, pero de unas semanas después, bueno, cuando fuimos a la luna de miel con Flavio, me fui con Flavio, de verdad le dije, yo creo que de verdad creo que sí me afectó y me lastimó mucho, pero yo pues decidí pues entregárselo a Dios y caminar con Dios, pero verdaderamente a través de este sermón Dios me enseñó de que todavía tenía ese dolor. Y nada más pues por ese sermón y por ese sermón pues Dios tocó mi corazón, me cambió mi vida y le doy gracias a Dios por el avivamiento.
Amen. Marcos.
Hey, how's everybody going at church? Here with Pastor this evening. Thanking God for what he's continued doing in our lives and in our church. Really thankful through this time. God's really been dealing with me and my, not really having a fear of what's going on, even through these times that we're going through. We're really seeing God's word coming, just popping up. So it's a really exciting time to be living and through this time. So, just his promises are still what really keeps me going. Also that we're not alone. We're not left as orphans in this world. God, we're adopted into his family and he loves us in that. So that's really exciting for me. Mm-hmm. And just keep coming to church. I hope to see in the few days we'll all be together again.
Amen.
Look at the fish you're making.
Just regular water.
Yeah, with
water.
Yeah, it was funny.
And I'm forgiven because you were forsaken, and I'm accepted. You were condemned, and I'm alive and well. Your spirit lives within me because you died and rose again. And I'm forgiven because you were forsaken, and I'm accepted. You were condemned, and I'm alive and well. Your spirit lives within me because you died and rose again. Amazing love, how can it be that you, my King, would die for me?
Oh, amazing love,
amazing love, I know it's true, and it's my joy to honor you in all. I'm forgiven because you were forsaken, and I'm accepted.
Yes, Lord.
You were condemned, and I'm alive and well. Your spirit lives within me because you died and rose again.
Oh, amazing love, Lord.
Amazing love, how can it be that you, my King, would die for me?
Sing amazing love.
Amazing love, I know it's true, and it's my joy to honor you in all I do. I honor you.
Hi everyone,
for all of you guys. Just wanted to say that I have to say I don't have no fear during this coronavirus thing. God has given me such a peace in my life. I know when all this came down, a lot of people were fearful, but I was pretty confident that I would be okay and that my family would be okay. I mean, God has really saved me and healed me from so many things in my life, and He's given me victory. And the only thing I think I hated was being home, and so that drove me crazy. And so I would like pace in my house, and I would have to go outside. And I know there's a lot of fear out there. We'd go to the store, and this one lady one time came up to me, and she's like, "Can you believe all this is happening?" And I felt so bad for her, but before I could say anything, she left. And I don't know if anybody is still experiencing fear or uncertainty, but I can tell you that God is with you, and He loves you, and He will protect you. And a scripture came to mind when I was thinking right now, but it's in 2 Timothy 1-7, and it says, "For God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind." And I mean, if anything, that'll give you confidence to know that God is with you and you're not alone. And Peter Jala, if you hear this, I want to thank you for coming during this time. And the words you spoke were very powerful and had broke some deep-rooted hurts in my life that I tried to cover up and not think of. And God has a way of exposing them and healing me. And I believe He's will mend my family, and excited for the things to come.
Amen.
Hello, everyone. Just here at Pastor's house. Actually, I felt having the fellowship and playing guitar and have everyone singing is something that I miss very much. Yes. That I miss from Bible studies, actually. But during these times, I think God has, the one thing I want to highlight the most is God's faithfulness and the way He's still, like, a lot of job sites got closed down, and you know, and just God has kept me, brought me to a place, because I got a new job at a new company, and it's one of the few places that are still working and very steady. So I thank God for that very much. And also, there's been a burden, because I keep in touch with some old friends, but a lot of them still, they don't really have, a lot of them have a fear, but they have no fear of God at all. They don't think that's the answer. And it kind of got me thinking a lot, because, you know, we do kind of feel like we need to step it up in our evangelism and during times like this. And I believe it's true. I do believe we're living the last days, you know. But at the same time, a scripture that comes to mind is when Jesus says that we'll be being married and eating and drinking, and you know, like in the days of Noah, and just out of nowhere it'll happen. So I think also what that's telling me is when all this is over, the coronavirus is over, it will not be a time to relax. Actually, in the good times, just because things are well, doesn't mean we should hold back, but we should even preach the gospel that much more. Mm-hmm. As well. So that's been in my heart as of recent, especially from a conversation that I have with one last night. And also the revival was also very powerful. I was also touched by the very same sermon that Perla was talking about the orphan spirit, which I fit some of those characteristics that Pastor Jala mentioned, and it was revelation to me. I was really touched also as well, and it was really powerful. But just God is faithful, and I believe God is going to really do great things in all of us. I believe He has done great things, but there are better things to come, especially when this is over, which I think will be over soon. So, amen. Bueno, también lo que quería decir es, algo que quería resaltar es la fidelidad de Dios, de cómo ha sido fiel, en que me ha puesto en un lugar en el trabajo donde Muchos trabajos los han cerrado y me ha puesto en uno donde está abierto porque no es parte de la ciudad, es parte de la ciudad, no del estado. Y por eso se abrió la oportunidad y nos están dando muchas horas. Entonces Dios ha sido fiel en mantenerme, en darme trabajo durante este tiempo. Y soy muy agradecido por eso. También del Pastor Peter Ayala, el avivamiento cuando vino. Un sermón que de verdad me tocó era también, igual como dijo Perla, el del espíritu huérfano, que también me pasó lo mismo casi. Mi papá, cuando yo tenía 14 años, también se fue. Y me di cuenta que una de las características, yo también tenía ese espíritu. Entonces, de verdad que ese sermón me tocó. Y también una cosa más que se me olvidó decir, que estos tiempos del coronavirus, a veces pensamos que, bueno, estamos en los últimos días y creo que hay mucha verdad en eso y hay que predicar el evangelio, ¿verdad? Y especialmente a los que amamos, queremos hablarles y hacen preguntas, ¿verdad? Pero también cuando se acabe todo esto, la urgencia no se debe bajar. La urgencia debe seguir porque Jesús dijo que iba a venir en tiempos que nadie lo iba a esperar, en tiempos de... se van a estar casando, ¿verdad? Comiendo y bebiendo, ¿verdad? Y cuando, como los días de Noé, cuando uno menos espera. Entonces, hay que seguir con Dios porque Él es fiel y creo que va a hacer grandes cosas con nosotros.
You are not a God created by human hands. You are not a God God in need of anything we can give. You are God. That's just the way it is. You are God alone. From before time began, you are on your throne. You are God. You're unchangeable, you're unstoppable.
that's what you are. You are God alone. From before time began, you are on your throne. You are God alone. And right now, in the good times and bad, you are on your throne. You are God.
Faithful, stay faithful, and muchas gracias, hermanos. Este, le damos gracias por estar con nosotros en estos momentos y por mirarnos este, en vivo y a todo color. Thank you guys. God bless you. Dios los bendiga. Amén.